Here we have the Battlestar Galactica, which is the new version. And this is a model kit originally by Moebius, but in Europe it's sold by Revell. And that means there are a few changes in the accompanying booklet. And decals, these are the decals for the Revell version. Here's the Galactica logo, the insignia, it's going on the top. The landing strips, which can be lighted. These sections are to be glued on the inside of the area where the landing bays are retracted. But they're gonna be light anyway. This is interesting. This is the window for the museum part. It's a decal for the museum part window. Let's take a look at the booklet. It's a typical Revell. Here we have the paint numbers and the parts. These are the areas where the landing bays are retracted in. So this is the clear part, the engine. I'm not quite sure if it's the sublight or the light speed engines. There are four of them on each side, so there's five engines in total. That's where the decals are supposed to be going for the bay. Straightforward, here are the engines installed, four of them as I said. This section is the only section that had where there are windows, well, lighted windows. So I'm going to drill some holes in there to put a light in there. These are the landing bays. Here the landing bays are placed or glued onto the model. And the stand, including the rod. Well, the parts look relatively clean. These are the landing bays. These are the larger engines. They go on the bottom, I believe, on the model. The guns. Well, there are aftermarket parts for the guns, but they are not very cheap here in Holland, so I'm going to stick with these. So, and the second bag this is the part where the windows are going to go. You can look closely, you can see, if I can get it in focus, little windows which have to be drilled out. And there's a light going in there. Unmistakably, the head. Well, reasonably good details. It's not very sharp, but it'll work. This is the bottom side of the head. And the smaller engines which go on the bottom. This is the stand, the display stand. It's nicely engraved with the logo. Well, this is going to be glued on a box where the battery and the switches are to be installed. And here we have the main body. Top and bottom section. This is the bottom section. Now, this is peculiar. This looks like it's damaged when it was in the box. It's not really visible after painted, but looks strange. This is the bottom section where the rod is going to be inserted. Although I can make a bigger rod to have the cables run through. And the clear parts for the engines, the larger engine in the back, and four smaller ones, and a metal rod. Okay, this is what I got in the mail a couple of days ago. I ordered it from Starship Modeler. No, Cult TV Man. That's why I ordered it. And these are additional decals. I never ordered these before. For the first time I built the Galactica, but I've seen models with these decals, so I thought I'd give it a try. Nothing else in there? No, there's nothing else in the envelope. Alright. What have we here? It's a plastic bag containing 3 large pages of decals. Small booklet, pamphlet with instructions on how to install those decals, and well, these look very complicated. We got decals for almost all the surfaces of the Galactica. The landing base, the main body, the head, engines. And, well, this is interesting. They also got decals for the landing bay. Point where landing bays are inserted in. So that's interesting. Well, they call it aztec, but these are the decals for the panels. And the ribs. Now, these have to be installed one rib at a time. You can't install it in one go. You need to cut them all one at a time. And a colorful booklet showing you where all the decals are going to go. And bottom section as well. Okay, looked like a lot of work, but looked like a fun job to do. Okay, so, but before I have to put the decals on, we have to paint it. And before we have to paint the model, need to be washed. All model kits you buy need to be washed in soapy water first, because of the some sort of a releasing solution which has been added in the factory to release the molds from the model, and these have to be cleaned so that the paint and the glue will be better sticking to your model. Don't have to really brush them, just a quick rinse in warm soapy water will be sufficient. And the bonus is you get your nails clean as well. Well, all they need now is to dry, and then we go on to the first part, which is base painting.